If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. It sorry says 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of the alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes.
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at insoria@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we can't guarantee a positive review. Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is a community option. $1 at the gate gets you in a Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. What? Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go on the village, facebook.com/VinandSori. There's 160,000+ people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community connection, friendship, that type of thing.
But, and it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sori and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 here and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
Buy our merch indeed. Excuse me, and a child shall lead them. To buy our merch. Waiting for Vinny to return. I am trying to download this video for us. And I'm not having a whole lot of luck. Okay, I think we got it. Yes, I believe we have it now. Okay. All right. Whoop. Okay. I have a feeling. This is the song I know. Ready?
Really?
Yeah.
What's the name of the song?
Well, it's called Escape, but because it says the Pina Colada song, I'm pretty sure it's a very interesting storyline. Let's just say.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
All right. It took me 1,000 years to get that downloaded, but I think it's there, so.
Okay.
If it's not, figure it out yourself. I don't want to hear about it.
Hey, Michelle in the house. All right, guys, here
it
we go.
Sick. Okay. Wait till you see this storyline.
Rupert Holmes. What'd you say? Escape?
Yeah. The Pina Colada song.
All right, let's go. What year is this? 1972.
I'm pulling it up. Yep. Definitely. 79. Have you heard it?
No. Still the lyrics?
I was tired of my lady. Been together too long, like a worn-out recording of a favorite song.
And you just got old on me, bitch.
So while she lay there sleeping, I read the paper in bed, and in the personal columns there was this letter I read. If you like pina coladas.
While he's in the bed with his girl?
He's reading that column and he's like, yo, that sounds good.
Oh my god, she's doing this. How's he getting away with this? He's doing this girl so dirty. Why do you like the song?
I didn't think about my lady. I know that sounds kind of mean. But me and my old lady have fallen into the same old old routine. So I wrote to the paper. Took out a personal ad.
I'm nobody's poet. I thought it wasn't half bad. Yes, I like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain. I'm not much into health food. I am into champagne. I've got to meet you by tomorrow noon and cut through all this red tape.
He's like trying to hook up with this girl while his wife's in the fucking bed next to him.
So I waited with high hopes, and she walked in the place. I knew a smile in an instant.
It's his girl.
The curve of her face. It was my own lovely lady. And she said, Oh, it's you. Then we laughed for a moment. I said, I never knew that you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain and the feel of the ocean and the taste of champagne. If you like making love at midnight in the dunes of the Cape, you're the lady I've looked for. Come with me and escape.
Why you were, wondering how the hell you were like so up spirited,
so okay with this song?
Fucking song.
She started it.
What do you mean she? No, she didn't start it.
Yeah, she did. She put the ad out
she
first.
She put the ad in the paper.
Yes.
Right. Yo, yep. I saw. I'll never forget this. I was in the Bronx. I was 15 years old that summer, and it was a. I think it was Maury Povich, and they were talking about, like, how to stay married. And they had this...
Don't do that.
They had this couple, and they were, like, 65 years old and married for, like, 40 years or some shit. And they're like, so what was your secret? And they're like, well, you know, not take yourself too seriously, blah, blah, blah. And they were like, yeah, that's important. And so Maury was like, well, what are some examples? And she's like, well, I caught him cheating on me. That obviously, you know, whatever, when you're young, you know, whatever. And then, she was like, well, how'd you get over it? She's like, well, basically I had known he had made a mistake. And then the husband looks at her and he goes, you also cheated on me after. She's like, well, yeah, that too. And like, so, like, he looked at her, and then they both busted out laughing, and they were like, yeah, you know, and he tried to leave a couple times, and I tried to leave a couple times, but we both knew that we weren't gonna, and, like, they were past it, like, you could tell that she really wasn't hurt by it, he was no longer hurt by it, you know, I think, you know, they're looking at the next phase of your life, it's over, you know what I'm saying,
yeah.
Like, they just didn't care, like, they both just didn't care, and I'm like, yo, like, I could never be like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could just never be that type of individual. But it was fascinating to see.
My gosh, he's like revenge cheating.
Who said that?
Wagyu.
Yeah, Wagyu. Yeah. But, like,
I forgot what it wasn't. I forgot which philosopher it was that basically said that most of our suffering is just meaning that we're pouring into an event or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, like,
yeah.
And I do, because like I've been in situations like that, and I've been in other situations relationship wise, and one hurt a lot more than the other. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what?
I'm being general because I'm, you know.
Yeah, I know you're being really vague, and so I'm having a hard time to follow.
But my point is, like,
some situations bothered you more than others,
right? And a lot of it had to do with the meaning that I poured into the situation.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what
I'm
saying? Like, but I just would never ever want my daughters to ever have that. Like, and maybe I'm too young. I'm not mature enough for it, but. But like I said, they looked happy with each other. They did. They looked happy with each other. They basically said, the guy said, hey, I tried other whatever. Like, the grass was never greener than her. Like, he was just like, you know, some girls would have her on this, this, and that. But she had the whole package. And she would kind of look at him and basically like, you can never escape me. It was like such a weird... But I also respected it. Like, I was not drawn to it like, that's what I want. But it was one of those things, like, I really respected those two, like, the way that they were. Because, like, you could tell that they had made it, and literally the only thing that was going to separate them was death. Like, they had completely figured out the whole unconditional love thing. They had it completely figured out. But, you know, I'm still young, man. I don't have it like that to where... Like, I would forgive, but I wouldn't be able to, like, look at it that way, like, ha. Because they both basically intentionally, their intention was to cheat on each other. But instead of him saying, you dirty hoe, I'm out of here. Like, he's like, well, oh, okay, well, since we are crazy, because, you know, our relationship was getting a little, you know, boring to him, I guess. So he's like, oh, well, if you would go to these lengths, then you're probably crazy. Crazier than I thought. Maybe you're not really boring. And my point is, like, he just saw her.
Oh, my gosh.
But, like, if you look at the song, like, he sees her in the bar, and it's her.
Yeah.
And he knows what she's there for. And instead of him saying, you dirty, you know, he goes, oh, well. Then,
well, they both had that response.
That's what I'm
to
saying.
Yeah.
Like, that, it reminded me of that couple from that show.
Yeah, no, I can see that. I just think, oh, man. I do agree with that. Like, I remember, like...
Yeah, much love, Michelle. Yeah, go ahead.
I remember, like, when I was... Like, there were certain things in my past relationship that was, like, really bothering me with his interactions with other women and stuff. And I'm like, okay, well, at the end of the day, like... Let's say, like, he's obsessed with a certain body part on another woman. I'm like, we're talking about... Like fat cells and skin. I mean, that's what we're talking about. It's not like, you know, but it still, it just hurt so much that it was hard to like kind of keep that mindset about it. But I do think that like if two people are like, I do agree with that to a degree. Like, you know, it is the amount of meaning that you pour into it. I don't think that that's something that you can convince yourself of or tell yourself to like get yourself away from being so hurt or so upset. Like, convince yourself that it's that you're going to pour less meaning into it. I think that, you know, perhaps, like, as you get older, like, that you would just be like, yeah, I mean... But then I've seen people that are older, like, you know, 20 years older than me, and I still see them obsessed with the same things. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think that is a... That's a certain level of maturity that those two people got to where they were like, you know what? At the end of the day, you know, in... This you're probably gonna think is crazy. I don't see how. Like, I think that if there's like cheating that happens, like, that's so much for the one person to have to like, get over, that. I don't think that revenge, cheating is good. But at the same time, like. I'm not sure like that you could. Like, I think that there has to be that. This is so bad to say. Like, I can see how if you even the scoreboard like that, well, now we both did it to each other, so I can see how that would make it... Because if one person cheated on the other one, and then the other one is always the hero because they never did it, and they're always looking at the other person like they're a shitty person, like, I just don't know if a relationship can... I feel like the relationship has a better chance if, like, both parties are like, well, you know, we both fucked up.
You are so funny.
Why?
I'm not even going to touch that. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you. I hear you. I just think that they're... At the end of the day, I wish I could find the episode because it would be interesting to watch it, but... It's either Montel Williams or Maury Povich, but pretty sure it was Maury. But, and now, like, this is... Those two are probably dead right now. Now that I think about it.
Yeah.
Because they were 60-something, like, 15 years ago. You know, well, it's 20. Yeah, I was 15. So, yeah, they're those two are probably gone. You see what I'm saying? Like, that shit is just crazy. Like,
yeah.
But it, you know, and then I think to myself, I truly don't believe in the physical world presently constructed anymore. So then I say to myself, okay, so what is happening in sex then? Since all of this is just iconography, what is happening and why is that such a sacred act? If it's physical and all of this is just an extremely elaborate, like, it obviously means something, but that like presents a whole different other set of questions to me that also makes that couple, that older couple who figured it out, seem to be so much more pragmatic, mm-hmm. so much more practical. It was like they figured out, like, yeah, this physical stuff is not really...
Well, I think that...
Like, it's like they figured something out.
Yeah, I mean, look, I'm not saying I'm anywhere close to that. I'm just saying, like, I think that if you look at it like, okay, you have... It is a physical act, obviously. But then there is something deeper that connects you. Well, there are times where... there are times where people are doing, like, that act, and they're not really trying to necessarily, like, connect deeply with the other person. It's just about sex. Like, yeah. Really, like, about their own personal, like, getting off, I guess you could say. And both parties are like that. And so because of that, it's almost like the experience is centered around themselves rather than with each other.
Whoa. I think we lost sound. No, sound is good. Go ahead.
So maybe the two of them really, like... Maybe they just connected with each other on a deeper level. And so they were like, I mean, obviously that was probably a difficult time in their relationship. But at the same time, like, they had a deeper connection than what they felt like their partner shared with someone else.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. What'd you give this one?
Oh, this one's a... This was a 10 for me.
It's a solid 9 for me.
Oh, a 9?
Yeah.
Why? Now, why did you give it a 9? I thought you were going to, like, give it some low score.
Well, I like the irony.
It has a little catchy tune to it, too.
I like the irony. I wouldn't listen to the song again, but I like the irony. The Vincent song and then the previous song.
The Vincent one was depressing.
But... I feel like I can relate to it. I feel like I'm an artist. I feel like I got a lot of greatness, and people misinterpret your homie. So that song was very, very meaningful to me. It was a very meaningful song to me. Like, it was a deep song. And then the other song I liked just because of the brilliance of the storytelling. Yeah. But as far as, like, enjoying a song and, like, connecting with a song, that Vincent song was the song for me.
Oh, yeah. Like, I don't feel this one deep in my soul or anything. I just find it an enjoyable song, and I like the... I think that the sound is a little bit catchy. This was, again, one of the songs when I was 15, when I was working at that, like, little, basically, like, a JCPenney store. Only much more, like, more pretentious. When I was working over there, this was one of the songs that was on rotation. And anytime I heard this one, because it was a story, I was like, okay, because it was a lot of older songs, not many that I could, like, really appreciate. But this was one of them that I liked the story, and I liked the kind of the banter between the two of them, and that the way that it worked itself out. Although I didn't think that long term that would work. Like, the fact that both of them did that, like, I don't know, yo, that's kind of... You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, both people are And then you just happen to bump into each other. Great. I mean.
Yeah, and then they're cool with it.
Yeah. Well, I mean.
That's what I'm saying. They were too bored. They were too bored.
Yeah. It's kind of like one of those moments where you're like, ah.
Too bored. That shit would never. That wouldn't happen over here.
No, it really wouldn't. If something like that happened, and like both of us did what was in the song, like that meetup would not be like a funny. It wouldn't. I'd be like, motherfucker. And you'd be like, you.
Well, that'll never happen, so no. That'll be good, because no. I would never do such a thing.
And I don't read the newspaper.
Having said that, dear listener.
Okay.
Shout out to the big homie DJ Nick. It felt a little weird, I'm not gonna lie, to have a DJ Nick night on a Thursday, not a Friday. Like,
I know, yeah.
I don't know what's gonna happen to the time space continuum.
Yeah.
But I thoroughly enjoyed it. Shout out to the big homie DJ Nick. We gotta get some of this energy out here. Oh, it's gonna be louder than that. Gang. Go ahead. What were you gonna say?
We've got another stream tomorrow around 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
That's gonna be a long one. So bring your popcorn, because we're looking at between 8 and 9 songs.
Oh, a mega stream, so maybe an ultra combo. Have a good night, DJ Nick in the house. We are out of here, beautiful people. Vin out.